do what you wanna when you get up in the morning. Cause it won't be long before you're dead and gone.
Yeah,
no, there ain't no telling. Yeah, we all just bet. Just plan our hand till the last stand. So tell your mama you've been spreading honey, won't you? Tell your brother you've been spreading honey, won't you? Tell your sister you've been spreading honey, won't they? Come along and spread some honey too. Oh, won't they? Come along and spread some honey too.
What is going on, everybody? How we all doing? We're gonna get started real soon.
It's them that's crazy. I'm just raising them rats. I'm making dough get fat, hanging up their hat. Nah, we ain't living like that. So tell your mama you've been spreading honey, won't you? Tell your brother you've been spreading honey, won't you? Tell your sister you've been spreading honey, won't they? Come along and spread some honey too. Oh, won't they? Come along and spread some honey too.
You guys hated me on Stardust last night. God damn. I go on a Stardust panel, my fucking viewership dies. Stardust, you fucked me.
Come along and spread some honey too.
Song or two, and then we're gonna get started. Guys, hear that? The non-alcoholic beer has been cracked.
You are.
That is the most fucked up idea for a mixed drink I've ever heard. I love that. Where's CJ? There he is. It's CJ, looking retarded as always. What a stupid looking fuck. I can't believe I came to see his stream. Thank you guys for stopping by. You know, we were here yesterday. We did a little stream yesterday, but I got a little bit sidetracked. We ended up going on Stardust panel, and my fucking viewers will not let me hear the end of it. They've been coming in my chat like, CJ, you're better than these fucking scumbags. What are you doing in Stardust stream? I'm sorry, I'm trying to be friends with Stardust now, okay? I did the stupid fireball panel, and my teammate fucking played porn with Keemstar saying the N-word in it, and then my other teammate ended up doxing another guy on the show, so I'm kind of fucking, I'm on my own. The only person that was nice to me was the person I was competing against, so Stardust, you are now, unfortunately, friends for life with me, and you're going to have to fucking deal with that. And I'm telling you, there's going to be a whole sort of like re-education camp element to me and Stardust relationship where we just need to get her out of the fucking Twitch politics bullshit. She can't be a fucking orbiter of Destiny anymore, okay? It's one thing to watch Destiny. It's another thing to be a fucking Destiny orbiter. It's like the most pathetic thing in the fucking world. I've been getting into some beefs with some of these Destiny orbiters, too. This guy, Wicked Supreme, on fucking Twitch. He is such a little cunt. That guy fucking got under my skin. Normally, I'll tell you this. I normally like Wicked Supreme because when it comes to argumentation and shit like that, he's very good. But when it comes to not being from California, he does extremely bad. He's very passive-aggressive California. He does stuff like, actually, would you mind, like, not talking about that topic? You know what I mean? Like, that sort of, like, smug fucking California arrogance. That guy drives me fucking insane. He pissed me off today. And I feel like Stardust can be de-radicalized, you know? Because on one end, you have all the cozy TV people that weirdly have attached themselves to Stardust. Then you have, like, fucking Flamenco, which that is insane how Stardust has not just denounce Flamenco. That, to me, is the biggest mark on her character, the fact that she won't fucking say Flamenco's a bad guy and that she's friends with him. It's like, okay, this fucking creep lied about being... He was 35 years old. He said he was, like, 20 to be friends with all these, like, young boys. Is that not enough to not be friends with somebody? So that she's got the Nick Fuentes people, the Michael Albertos, the fucking Flamencos, and then on the other side... You have the Destinies, you got the Wicked Supremes, the Irrelevants, and it's like they're all a bunch of fucking losers. Stardust, we need to get you watching fucking Red Bar. You gotta start watching normal-ass shit. Get out of this fucking Twitch bullshit. You're surrounded by weirdos. And I gotta tell you, too, Stardust has the most insane people surrounding her. I don't know what the fuck it is, but she has all these, like, very, very weird, creepy internet people that have this, like... parasocial crush on her. She's like the Indian stepsister poly what do you call it, parasocial fucking sock dem girl of Twitch. It's very dark, very disturbing, and you know, she's my friend now though, so I have to support her. But anyway, thank you guys for coming by. Really, the reason why I decided to do this stream today is because last night, through all this drama, Salvo Pancakes has been fucking... This whole drama, it has been so telling. All this editor drama with Salvo Pancakes. And I'll tell you why. It's because the people in the commentary community are too autistic to be able to tell what's real and what's fake. That's what it really boils down to. It is extremely easy to trick basically anybody in the commentary community. I mean, like, we've been proving this time and time again. Look at Smaggle. We just started a rumor that fucking Smaggle's been DMing non-binary teenagers. Everybody fucking buys it. Smaggle looks like an idiot. You just tell these people anything and they'll just fucking take your word at face value. It's insane. So, lo and behold, there's this editor who, he didn't get paid $70 and it's all Salvo's fault, and Keemstar is going to have to fire Salvo because he just can't have this in his ranks. Salvo commissioned this guy and said that the Keemstar show owes him money? Like, I'm going to tell you this. Let me be really fucking transparent with you guys. When I heard that Salvo, he owed an editor $70, I was kind of like, whoa, I don't like that. I don't like hearing that this guy that I'm friends with is fucking running up debts with different people. I'm going to get work with this guy. I'm not going to pay him. I mean, in my opinion, that's a fucked up move. I don't like that. And, you know, I was kind of keeping my mouth shut a little bit because it was, I don't know, something that I don't like. But as time has gone on, Salvo has been 100% fully vindicated in this entire scenario. He came out on top. All the allegations against him have come out to be, all of them have been false. There's two main accusations. Both of them are bullshit. So the first one is for the Keemstar show, and then the second one is for like an editor that he commissioned for his personal YouTube page. And through this stream, we have evidence that all this shit is bullshit. And in fact, the people that ended up going after Salvo, we have some pretty fucking good evidence that they've been up to some shady fucking shit on their own accord. Somebody like Nicholas DiOrio, for example. So we're going to be talking about some of the accusations against him. And it's like, why are they even fucking trying? Like, Nicholas DiOrio, who else has been fucking this up? Apparently this Dead on Dave guy, who I don't even fucking know. I'm sure Doc on the Radio has fucked it up because he's stupid. Everybody's been fucking this whole story up because it's people get too excited about breaking news. You know what I mean? People get too excited about breaking news. They see something happening and they want to make the first tweet about it, but they don't just fucking sit back and wait for like a little bit more information. Okay. Because if you did that, then you wouldn't come out of this with a bunch of fucking egg on your face. Like, Bowblax is going to. Bowblax really has proven himself to not know anything about freelancing, about working, about being in professional society. I mean, this guy doesn't get it. He just doesn't fucking get it. And, you know, I went into the Salvo slash Bowblax phone call just assuming that I'm going to take Bowblax's side, because up until this point, frankly, I've agreed with Bowblax on a lot of what he says, and I was willing to hear him out, and I'm like, oh, maybe Salvo's up to no good. Maybe the situation is not what I thought it was. Maybe me being on the Salvo news team is going to fuck my chances up in the future. Oh, no! He's on the Salvo news team. We can't hire him. Turns out we win yet again. We win every time. I don't know why people go after us. It's insane. It's fucking stupid. Clara, if you're still up for it, if you want to hop in my Discord, I would love a lore master in here. So, oh, sorry, Clara. Sorry, Clara. Not Clara. Clara, which is much nicer. Clara, except for Clara. So much nicer. But yeah, if you want to hop in for a couple minutes, maybe clear up some stuff that I might have gotten wrong or whatever. Then we are going to get into the Bowblax stream, the 8-hour stream, where he says a lot of stupid shit. And then Augie and Nicholas DiOrio say a bunch of stupid shit afterwards. but we also have all the screenshots of the editor's messages to Salvo. So we're going to be reading those on stream. And yeah, we got a lot of stuff to go through here. We got a lot of stuff to go through. I think we should start off by going into. I see you guys all in here, by the way. I'm just trying to mosey on through here. Let me see here. So
CJ on top. He gonna suck your cock. He gonna get you smoking on that cock. Oh shit, he is a bitch. Oh shit, yeah, and maybe he's a snitch on the Savo News team. It's a cream dream. It's gonna make it obscene. Suck on my D. Fuck.
Man, I can't fucking freestyle. I wish I knew how to fucking freestyle. God damn it. All right, let's see here. It was on like Bowblax's secondary channel
playing
or something.
For the first time. And-
okay, we got that. And then we're going to open up the time codes too. I have diligent time codes of all this shit, man. Look at this. Oh. Okay, 1820. Bowblax replies to Salvo in the chat. So up until this point, Bowblax has been talking about this situation. He's been going on and on about how Salvo doesn't pay his editor. And I guess what he's been doing is going in the group chat with all their hidden group chat. These guys, they all have fucking hidden gay-ass group chats where they'd be like, oh, you're taking things too far. Oh, blah, blah, blah. They're all gossiping. So I guess Bowblax has been gossiping like a woman in the group chat. And Salvo decides to get on stream because he sees him talking about this on the stream. Or maybe, I think maybe even Salvo brings it up. But Salvo is upset about how Bowblax is talking to him in the group chat, from what I understand. And from there, Salvo pops in the chat, and then we can play the video. Okay, here we go.
I don't know where to go or what to do. Like, this is definitely the worst mission in the game. And I know this game, like, pretty decently, and it took me, like, hours and hours.
But, I mean, like, look at this stream, by the way. So he's playing Sonic the Hedgehog. He's got, like, a neck brace on, sitting in the corner. I mean, he's looking like, what do you call it? Sid the Sloth from Ice Age.
This is just, like, the fruits of my labor, you know? How's the investigation going?
Okay, so that was Salvo in the chat right there. How is the investigation going? That's what he says.
Guy already showed me that you fucking,
Yeah, what are the... First of all, anybody that is... I mean, I know Salvo said this a couple months ago, but it is so true. Listen, I'm on documentary 45 of the 67-part Chris Chan documentary series, and I am confident about one thing and one thing alone, and that's adults who are into Sonic are fucking suspect.
Bam.
That's... I mean, that is just a fact. If you are into Sonic as, like, an adult man, that's really fucking suspect.
Oh,
the video audio is quiet. Okay, thank you. See, this is why it's so much better doing this live. If I have like an issue like that, you guys can just tell me, and then we can just move on.
To him to do. I just told you.
Oh, wait. Hold on. Do I have my camera on in the corner? I don't. See, Stardust fucked my shit up so bad.
I told you it's like retarded as fuck to like ask for an editing job, and then. And say you're gonna pay someone, then when you don't like it, you just decide not to pay them. Like, it's just stupid.
Okay, so this is his line of argumentation. Let's pay attention to this. Okay, so this is kind of like the, this is like the crux of what Bowblax is trying to say. This is the point he's trying to make. Professional internet commentator Bowblax. Let's hear his opinion about this.
Ask for an editing job.
Okay, if you ask for an editing job.
I just told you in DMs, because I told you it's like, retarded as fuck to like ask for an editing job and say you're gonna pay someone, then when you don't like it, you just decide not to pay them. Like, it's just stupid. So
okay, so I mean we can already start to see how ridiculous this is. So you're saying like, you said that there may or may not be money involved, so therefore, that means you have to pay him regardless of how good the quality of the video is that you get back.
I was just letting you
turn
know,
him on more.
You don't care, so, I mean, it is what it is.
And look at that. We can see Salvo in the chat. How's your investigation? Fake news. Fake news is being said right there.
He can come out with it if he wants to, but, I mean, my job's done. I've already just, you know, told you what I think, and that's about it.
My job is done. Okay, so now we're getting into the mentality of these commentary people. My job is done. I'm Bowblax. I reported on the breaking news, you know, without really knowing much about the situation. I'm going to give you my breaking news, and my job is done. I don't need to get the story right. I don't need to know anything about what's going on. I just need to believe whoever tweets at me with evidence,
you know, whether or not it's true or not. I just have to spread that around, and I've done my job on Bowblax. I'm going to keep playing Pikmin 4 in Sonic.
If I wanted to expose you, I wouldn't have told you anything in DMs. So,
you can trust me. If I wanted to expose you, I wouldn't have sent anything in DMs. Oh, that's nice of you.
Oh, I missed two? Well, whatever. Fuck this level.
Okay, so that's like when Salvo enters the chat. So we can see kind of what he's saying right there. And already, I mean, it is just such a fucking stupid line of argumentation. And I'm telling you this. My friends are professional video editors. I have friends that make hundreds of thousands of dollars every year editing videos professionally, freelance. And I talked to one of them earlier today, and he gave me his opinion as a professional video editor about who is right or wrong in this scenario. So later on, we're going to go through that, and we're going to see like what an actual professional person has to say about this shit. Okay, Salvo joins the call at 28 minutes. And I like watching this from his perspective, too. We get to watch Sonic. I mean, why can't these guys just sit at their fucking computer and talk into a microphone? Why are they playing video games? Is there a single person in Bowblox's community that is watching Sonic the Hedgehog? Who is this for? What, like... You could even be playing Sonic the Hedgehog, and that could be off camera, and you could be the entire screen. Like, why am I watching you play Sonic the Hedgehog? It doesn't make any sense. It has no relationship with the content at all. It is a weird... you know who really is responsible for making people feel comfortable doing this? Destiny. Destiny does these full pieces of content where... The content has nothing to do with the video game, but he's still playing the video game, and it's just so trashy and bad.
What's up?
Stop saying Bowblax. What am I supposed to say?
Bobby.
Yep.
So why are you going on and saying that I owe this kid money? Where in the messages do you see that I owe this kid money? Tell me.
You made a tweet saying, I need editors, I'll pay you big, and then he responded being like, hey, I saw your Twitter, you want me to do this?
You have proof of that?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna go over this really slow. It's only an 8-minute call, so we can really listen to this.
Bobby.
Okay. Yeah.
So why are you going on and saying that I owe this kid money? Where in the messages do you see that I owe this kid money? Tell me.
You made a tweet saying, I need editors, I'll pay you big, and then he responded being like, hey, I saw your Twitter, you want me to do this?
I mean, how the fuck is Bowblax thinking this is good? Dude, you made a tweet saying there may or may not be money involved, so therefore you have to give him money? How much money is he supposed to give him? Like, how does that make any fucking sense at all? So the guy just makes a video. Like, so from Bowblox's perspective, this 15-year-old kid could have sent Salvo, like, ISIS beheading videos at 240p, and Salvo would have owed him money because he agreed to... He tweeted about it or something? Like, how does that make any fucking sense?
You have proof of that?
Yes.
Okay, so that guy, Janky Shiny... was begging me and asking me for months for work. I put that tweet out.
So we're gonna listen to this call, and then we're gonna look through the full DMs. We have all the DMs between these people.
Messages me, okay. Right?
Yes.
Okay. I ask him to edit down a stream into 20 minutes. He delivers a 2-hour file that's in 360p quality.
Okay. And it's like at that point when Salvo says that, it's like it should be like end of story. He delivered him, so Salvo asked, okay, so when you're freelancing, what you're doing is you're providing a product, right? So for me, I work professionally. I freelance professionally, right? So I give bike tours of Central Park. I give a 2-hour informational bike tour of Central Park. So on that tour, I am expected to do a 2-hour informational tour about Central Park. I can't bring them to Harlem to buy crack. That's a different tour. That's not what they paid for.
Okay.
Okay.
No.
A fucking 2-hour, so it's a 2-hour stream, and he cuts it down to 2 hours? And then gives him the quality, 360p? What the fuck? They don't even, they use 360p in like fucking Tajikistan. That's not like an American aspect ratio.
Money was discussed ever with him in the tweet.
Like, how the fuck is Bowblax confused by, I literally don't understand how he's confused by this. It doesn't make any fucking sense. There's no rational person that would tell you if I paid for a 20-minute video of a certain clip that they would give back a 2-hour video in 360p. How the fuck could he ever come to the conclusion that this kid deserves money?
Different. He didn't discuss any money. We didn't discuss any money. He delivers me a
no money. That's so important too. No actual amount of money was discussed. So no actual amount of money was discussed. Doesn't make any fucking sense.
2-hour stream when I asked for 20 minutes and three.
And it's so funny because, you know, these like Augie and Nick and Bowblax, they'll accuse Salvo of manufacturing drama. This is manufactured drama, okay? This is a fucking manufactured fake ass drama story. This is not real. This is fucking fake news. This is like how Jackson Hinkle reports on Russia.
160p quality.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
So, again, you're saying I owe him money. How much money do I owe?
Well, however, that's like for you and him to decide.
That's for you and him to decide. Oh, yeah. Good point there, idiot.
Right. And we didn't discuss it.
With the promise
and we didn't discuss it, Josh. Hey, Josh, you're absolutely right. And we didn't discuss it. So how much money do I owe him, Josh? Because you keep running your fucking mouth.
You need to discuss
how much money do I owe him, Blowy? Blowy, how much money do I owe him?
Yeah, Salvo's kind of getting... I don't know if Salvo's like... he's like kind of puffing his chest right here, too. Can you imagine fucking Salvo coming up to you fucking doing this, Bobby.
You have to discuss the amount.
Salvo's so fucking mad right here. This is one of the first times that you've seen Salvo actually angry because somebody is doing him dirty. That's kind of what's happening right here. Salvo's getting done dirty by Bowblax. You know, a lot of the time, Salvo, you could tell he's like kind of hamming it up. He's having fun. He's just doing a show. He's, you know, having fun on the internet. And right here, he does seem genuinely kind of upset.
Yeah. And did we do it, Josh? Did we discuss the amount? Josh.
No.
Right.
Well, not that
so
I
why
know.
Are you continuing to run your fucking mouth saying I owe him money then?
Well, if he did a job with the expectation of being paid because you said you would pay.
If he did a job, you know, it's like, okay, let's say my job was to scoop ice cream at an ice cream store and I'm paid an hourly rate and I'm expected to scoop ice cream for that amount of time. What if I just sit in the bathroom and jerk off all day? Am I still expected to get the money? You know, it's like to get paid, you have to do the job that you promised to do. And if you didn't do the job that you promised to do, then you don't get paid. Sorry, Charlie, that's not how it works.
Greatly, quote unquote, in the tweet, then if he does the work, you should pay him.
It's absolutely.
If he does the work, you should pay him. But he, again, it's like he did not do the work. The work is the product. Like, I don't know if this is the thing. Like, Bowblax has never worked a job before. So he doesn't understand the difference between being a freelancer and being an employee of something. So if you are an employee, you get an hourly rate where, you know, you're expected to do certain things for a certain period of time. But if you're a freelancer, you submit invoices. So I created X product for X amount of money. You submit an invoice and then they pay you. And if you did not fulfill your end of the invoice, then you do not get paid. This is not confusing. The fact that Bowblax took this as a W is super embarrassing, and it shows that he is living in a state of arrested development. But do I need to fucking say that? He's playing Sonic the Hedgehog right now.
Hey Josh, I've outsourced $590 this year to the community for work. $590.
Okay, if but the I'm money, talking about this specific Josh, incident.
I'm getting there, retard. Shut the fuck up.
Jesus.
If the money's discussed, it gets paid. I didn't discuss money with him. You said, absolutely. If the money's discussed, he should be paid. Now tell me again, Josh.
I mean, and it's like, I don't even have to show you the fucking DMs because this is like, this. To me, any normal human being can see this and see who's winning this argument. You know, I don't even need to see the DMs. The points that Salvo are making, these are correct points. Salvo is somebody that has existed in the workforce. You know, he understands this shit.
I'm gonna run your mouth.
I didn't say
how much money do I owe him if we discussed money? How much? Give me an amount, Josh.
No, you need to
zero because we didn't discuss anything, right? Okay. Zero because we didn't discuss anything, right, Bowblax?
But yeah, but you discussed that you would be paying him.
You just get to 0101001100. Oh, it actually makes sense, but I can't admit it because I'm in the middle of an argument. Fuck you.
Did him and I discuss money?
Listen, I am so... I mean, guys, like, how exciting is it that we get to do this stream as a victory lap instead of, like, me having to prove who's right or wrong? No. We're going to see later on that there is... So this is the first editing drama. There's a second editing drama. There have been two total editing dramas. Salvo has been vindicated from both of them. The tides have turned. The fan bases are now seeing that Salvo won. And now this stream is a fucking victory lap. So congratulations, everybody, that fucking kept your mouth shut and just waited for all the info to come out instead of looking like a bitch and saying some bullshit.
As far as I know, you didn't negotiate the specific amount.
Okay, then why are you telling everybody that I owe this 15-year-old who didn't do the fucking job and did it poor, that I owe him specifically money then, if we didn't discuss money?
I told you privately that you probably should pay him if you told him.
Why is he privately telling him he needs to give money to these incompetent idiots?
For a day. I said, hey, get all the info. Get all the info and come back to me. You want to talk on stream like I owe him money?
I never said I wanted to talk on stream.
So how much would I be sending to him if no monetary amount was discussed, Bowblax?
Tell me, you would pay him, great.
I don't see why these people keep going after fucking Salvo, man. Listen, there's a reason why I started like working with Salvo. It's because I see what he's doing and it's working. You look at like what he did to Flamenco. You look at what he did to Def Noodle. And now you look at what he did to Bowblax and all these other guys. And he's fucking creaming them. And these guys, they've been fucking making videos since they've been 13 years old. They've been in this YouTube space. And they're getting absolutely fucking wrecked by somebody who jumped into the space like 6 months ago. So it's like, yeah, I shacked up with Salvo. I do content with him because he always seems to fucking win. It's like... It always just seems to work out, but with these guys, they don't know what's up from down. Their autism is too extreme for them to be able to tell the difference between what's real and what's fake. You know what I mean? These guys, they're so out of it, man. They're so out of it.
I owe him money.
You said you would pay him greatly. You said you would pay him greatly.
Dude, these guys way more than secretly want Salvo gone. Are you kidding me? You can imagine... So Salvo's in their little fucking group chats where they, you know, gossip about everybody because they don't have the fucking balls to say what they actually feel about people in the public. So they have their little group chats where they go into. I would bet you $100 the group chat that Salvo probably has with like Nick DiOrio and Augie and Salvo, there's probably a separate group chat with the same people with Salvo not in it where Salvo's talking and they're like, huh, this guy's going to get canceled within 2 months. It's like, that's the type of shit these guys do. Fucking high school girl bullshit. Lunch table drama bullshit. That's what these guys are into.
Yeah, great, but then you say Salvo Pancakes owes Janky Shining money, right? That's what you continue to say in the messages and on your stream. But we didn't discuss money. We didn't discuss anything with payment. Where am I sending this money? Where am I sending it to him? Did we discuss that? Did he give me an email?
You said you would pay him greatly. That's money, right?
You said you would pay him greatly. Okay, so I just tweet, I will pay you greatly, and now legally I owe him money. Wow, so smart, Bowblax. Good job using your fucking brain there.
It's money?
Much fucking Sonic the Hedgehog on the brain. Can't figure out how to do business.
I sent out a tweet.
And he responded to said tweet, and you responded to him and accepted work from him from the inquiry that you made in the tweet.
Josh, if money is discussed, it gets paid. I've outsourced $590 to the community this year.
Okay, but I'm talking about this specific...
Yeah, that didn't necessarily need to come up, because we'll see later, Bowblax uses that against him, where he's like, oh, Selvo said that he brought this up, but it's like, oh, but you should have paid for this time, though. And it's like, okay. So you're introducing information that I don't think needs to be introduced at that point. So you're just, with throwing this whole $590 number out, it's just, it's giving people too much, you know what I mean? Like, in a situation like this, you don't even fucking have to tell these people that shit. You don't owe them that fucking info. Like, all you need to talk about is this one particular dumbass situation.
Incident, like,
yes,
the fact
we
that
are talking about this.
People.
We're not talking about that, bro. We're not talking about that broad, vague tweet. Absolutely. We're talking about this specific incident.
Yes,
you keep saying Salvo Pancakes owns Janky Shunning money. How much money do I owe him, and where am I sending it, Josh? Tell me. Oh, wait, it's not in the messages, right? So why are you continuing to run your fucking mouth?
Yeah, exactly. It's not in the fucking messages. It's not in the messages. It doesn't exist. Like, why are you fucking getting all up in Salvo's business about a situation you don't even understand? You don't even understand the situation. Why are you putting yourself right in the middle of it? I fucking hate it when people do shit like this. They figure out a situation that they're not involved in. They put themselves right in the middle of it, even though they don't know what the fuck is going on. It's like, why? You're just adding more confusion and chaos. And they say, like, you know, Salvo is the chaos agent of the commentary community. Really? It seems like you're causing some chaos with some bullshit right now, so I don't know.
A message is that you
Shut
would pay him
off.
Greatly. Yell,
faggot. Shut up, faggot.
Okay. And he left.
And then there you go. So that was the phone call right there. That was Salvo. Just, you know, leaves calling the guy a faggotini Alfredo. Pretty funny. I think Salvo was actually pretty upset about that. It seems like he was pretty upset. very entertaining stuff. I figured now we'll go into the actual DMs here. What are you feeding her, Clara? What are you feeding her, Clara? Okay, here we go. There we go. All right. So now that we heard this, we're going to go through the full DMs that Salvo sent to this fucking kid. Okay. Let's see. Hi, it's me from Twitter. Can you send me the stream you want me to edit when you can and tell me requests if you need anything specific? Yo, what time zone, you king? What the... Salvo, learn how to fucking write! Learn how to fucking write, man! What the hell? I'm trying to read your shit! What time zone you in? And yeah, I will give you some notes. Okay, so he's going to give you some notes. Okay, cool. Then Salvo goes, Yo, Salvo, I just woke up. What's up? I'm in California right now. What's my time zone? What's yours? And then Salvo, Janky goes, I'll get to it today. Don't worry. If you need anything specific for, like, a part, you can tell me. Oh, okay. Fucking person did a horrible editing project. Look at how hard it is to read their fucking texts. If you need anything specific for, like, a part, you can tell me. It's over 5 hours. How are you determining what parts to include? I have some parts for sure. I'll keep the best parts, yada, yada, yada. Okay, so again, it's like all vague language, like, what are you going to do? What are you going to cut it up? I think we're going to get into more specifics right here. So it looks like Salvo is telling this kid what he's looking for when he's hiring the kid to make a video. Okay. The final length should be 20 to 30 minutes, I think. Yeah, let me give you some parts. All right. include the following, please. The jokes and shit about Stardust and Diva, Augie's sponsorship segment, My Mom Calls Me, Investigation on Ethan and Gila, Keemstar and Brantley part, quick montage about the gay ops against me, Flamenco Sacrifice, my rant about Augie giving Dead on Dave a shout-out and what it takes for me to get a shout-out. Feel free to add anything. And then he goes, I'll be sure to add all of those. What time zone are you in, by the way? Eastern, on Pacific. Okay, okay, perfect, man. Appreciate your help. Anytime, man. Include the part where I go into detail about Augie being a grooming victim to Flamenco. I like that. It's a good narrative. Spread that. and the comparison to a girl and her dance time. Or dance teacher, sorry. Timestamp, 3:51:40-ish. The dance starts, comparison starts at blah, blah, blah. Include this part, too, where I'm talking about Dead on Dave and Augie and his shout-out and how I don't get gigs, LOL. You got it. In the Klein segment. Okay, so all that text happened, 7:22. Okay, next day, 7:23. Let's see this. Hey, bud, any updates? Yeah, I got it downloaded and everything. I'm doing it right now. I saw the stream, too. Shit with AC was crazy. Oh, my God. You know this is a bad person, too, if they know who fucking AC is. Honestly, anybody who's, like, friends with, like, the doc on the radio people, you're fucking insane. You're friends with, like, Taps and Smaggle? Like, what the fuck? Do you know what kind of sick shit those people are doing? Dude hates my guts. Okay. A lot of people were talking about the Dumpy rant in Clipped, and I promoted it, and he got mad because of how... And this is the other thing with you fucking Discord people. You're all getting into such petty drama with all the other autistic people. Like, tighten up, okay? Stop going after other autistic Discord people. Start going after BX Bullet. Seriously. And he got mad because of how much it was being talked about and deleted everything about it. Sounds like him. Okay, the next day, yo, ETA, so Salvo's hounding him now. Today or tonight, smiley face, bet. Which, by the way, if you're smiley-facing men, that's really suspect. Gonna send you it today, right now. By the way, when I'm done, is it all right if I edit more stuff for you? Yeah, bro, nice, nice. How you gonna send it? Uploading it unlisted. Link me, nigga! Bet, yeah. Yo! Hey, Salvo, I heavily apologize. It's being processed on YouTube right now. Almost done when I was editing it. Crashed, so I had to restart. Okay, so already we're getting into some fucking excuses right here. Getting into some serious excuses here. Hey, Salvo, I heavily apologize. It's being processed on YouTube right now. Almost done when I was editing it. Crashed so hard I had to restart. Yada, yada. Excuse, excuse. You're good, bro. Just send that link over. We will scheme against AC in the SMP. Scheme against AC SMP. Yeah, you know, bitch. Now I'm getting creamed. Okay. So now, let's see. This is what he said. So I was asking Salvo for the original file. I think we should just take his word for it. I mean, I can understand if you guys don't believe it, but word on the street, it is a two-hour cut. We could see in the DMs, Salvo asked for a very specific thing. Very, very specific thing. He asked for a video between 20 and 30 minutes of certain things. And so this kid sends him a two-hour video in 360p. Look at this. Here, I'm going to show you this. God damn, why am I so gunked up? Look at the file name. Look at the file name. Salvo Pancak. This guy didn't even fucking spell his name right in the file. Salvo Pancak. I mean, Bowblax, you're a fucking idiot, man. Salvo should not... I mean, dude, these guys need to take like a two-week timeout or something. These guys, I mean, they need a serious fucking two-week timeout. You can't fuck up a story this bad and, you know, just expect, you know, bygones or whatever. It's like if you fuck up a breaking news story, you got to go for a little while. You got to take a little bit of a break. You know what I mean? You got to take a little bit of a break. Let me see if I can find. So that's the first drama, okay? So Salvo completely vindicated on that drama. I mean, if you guys don't believe me, then you're insane. But if you don't believe me, my friend is a professional video editor, and he's been working for, I want to say, the last 15 years as a freelance video editor. So he knows more about what the process is like for video editing than anybody that I know. So I asked him earlier today about what he thought about this drama. So let's see what he had to say about this.
Yo, what's up, dude? Hey, sorry, I can't join you tonight. Yeah, so you gave me the details of that. First thing I would say is that, like, as an editor, there is a very first thing I'm agreeing to is a price before I even...
Oh, wait, where'd it go?
Look at anything. I don't know why anybody would not agree to a price before they started working. Often, a lot of times with commercial editing... there'll be, like half of the estimate will be paid up front. That's not always common, you know, in smaller jobs, but, that is definitely in bigger jobs. That is always a thing that half gets paid up front. The other thing is, like, you know, I don't know, client relations, like there is a certain knack to explaining or understanding what a client needs. So as an editor, like, it's like, okay, so you're saying this, you know, you have a conversation of like, what's going to happen as far as this edit goes, you know, even if they don't understand all the lingo and, you know, tech speak, you know, there's a lot of times I'll show, if I feel like they don't understand me, I will like show some like, okay, so you're talking about something like this, you're talking about something like that. What are you using it for? Delivery specs are something I ask for at the beginning of the job or very early in the job. Like, what are we delivering at? Especially if it's something that's shoot, being shot, I have specs that I deliver to the production team on, you know, what I need as far as an editor, like how I edit. So, I mean, those are just things like, listen, this whole industry is getting like watered down. So you got to pick your jobs right. Like there are so many cheap jobs out there that like you're better off not doing them. And I would say if this editor got screwed, you know, it sounds like he did. Just, you know, it's a learning experience, man. Like, it's not necessarily that every YouTuber is going to screw you over, but how to prevent that. That's really, like, just minimize. You know, my whole thing is, too, is, like, communication is, like, how do I minimize the amount of back and forth that I have to do with this client? Like, if I can scale these emails back from, like, 20 to 12 emails, like, what's the best way to do that? So it's just everything is, like, crystal clear. Yeah, it's a pain in the ass.
Okay. One thing I love about that, too, is he's extremely black-pilled on editing as an industry at this point. But there you go. So that was a professional editor giving his opinion about this. I mean, you heard it clear as day. There's an art to, you know, knowing the product that your customer is looking for. You have to know what they're looking for, and you have to deliver the product that you promised to get them. So, clear as day. Seems like, I don't know, seems like Bowblax is really just going to have to take a tremendous L on this one, and, you know, sucks to suck. So we're going to get somebody in the call now. We're going to take some call-ins right now. Yo, 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 what's up, Sosa?
Hello, how are you?
How we doing?
Good, brother. I just woke up.
Okay, so we're talking about the whole Bowblax Salvo situation right now, and I guess Clara was saying that you know quite a bit about it.
Yeah, so like I guess I'm a conscientious observer in a sense, and I was watching it all, you know, unfold and that sort of thing, and basically, like, from what I can see, and I think this would be any logical adult, and you can correct me if I'm wrong there, but any logical adult can see, you know, shit like a group chat or even discussions of payment when it comes to business practices, and I believe this is how Salvo operates because he's an adult and he's worked in the business world. In a business sense, you aren't paid for work that you don't do properly, right?
Yes, that's what we've been saying this whole time.
If I'm wrong there. Exactly.
You're 100% right, man.
These YouTubers... These YouTubers have a different code, and their code is just, we decided this is the way, so you either go with us or you don't. It's like, nah, that's not how this works in real life, but mate, like, I'm sure if you go to a tattoo artist and, you know, you DM them, you go in for a booking and then shit changes, you can't go or whatever. Just because you've said you'll pay $200 doesn't mean you have to pay the $200. It's that fucking simple. Like,
you know what I found so interesting is Bowblax kept saying over and over again, like, he did the work, so you have to pay him. And Bowblax is so removed from, like, the workforce, he doesn't realize that the work was not done because the product wasn't made properly. That's the entire thing. It's not about your hourly rate. It's about... You agreed to make a product for a certain price. It's a different type of employment.
That's the thing with any freelance working. If you're going to provide a service in the arts or what have you, and I would consider video editing an art, I work.
Well, I would consider it a trade. It would be a trade, like where you're expected to do a certain job within a certain time period. So it's, you know what I mean? It's a trade.
It's the same as like music, right? You know, if I get commissioned to do vocals on a project or something and I do it and you know what, they don't want to use it, it doesn't sound good, I don't get paid for that. And that's fine. That's understandable. The project is not being used. The product is not being used. Therefore, the product has no monetary value.
I look at it this way. Market. It's like, okay, let's say Ariana Grande agreed to do a verse on Kanye West's new song. And instead of singing an Ariana Grande song, she just goes to like a local fucking homeless shelter and films a crackhead taking a shit on her iPhone.
Yeah.
And it's like, that's not what we agreed on. That's like a totally different fucking thing.
Absolutely. If you're expected to have a certain level of professionalism and a certain level of work and product, and you don't provide such a product, you shouldn't be paid for such a product. It's really, I don't know. To me, this shit seems so fucking simple, but maybe it's because, I don't know, you seem like a person who goes outside as well. So like people who aren't fucking terminally online and have had actual business interactions, dealt with money, dealt with discussions with businesses, things like that.
Well,
I've been working.
I've been, ever since I've been an adult, I've been working. I haven't been like making Minecraft videos to, you know, manipulate 13-year-olds into clicking on my ads. You know, it's like a different life that I've had.
Exactly. It's, you know what it is? You've had a normal human being life. You're not fucking terminally online. And that, here's the problem. It's terminally online kids trying to comment on people who conduct their business like actual functional adults. And it's just stupid. Like and they're trying to morally grandstand. It's like they don't have a leg to stand on. This is all a semantical debate on their end. Whereas everyone who's coming at it and understanding that Salvo is in the right, understanding, because that is the fact of the matter, he is in the right. Understanding that he is in the right here are people that have been in the workforce. People who have been in the workforce for a long time, done a lot of things in the workforce. And this online stuff is just, you know, fun side stuff to do in their, you know, day by day. I gave an example in the chat. It was like, you know, in a Twitter space, I jokingly said to Clara, I was like, Clara, will you marry me? Shit like that. You know, I was just fucking around.
Are you like one of these internet horny guys? We've had a lot of problems with like really serious horniness in my Discord. So if you're one of those we had to hire a horny police department to patrol my Discord. So if we start seeing any fucking weird shit that you're involved in, I'm telling you, we're going to come down hard on you.
Oh, yeah. No. And I fully expect that. I am someone, I have no skeletons in my closet. I'm not that sort of dude. Okay. I like to fuck around. But
I'm just making it clear.
Yeah. You're fine, brother. But what I'm saying is in the sense that this would be similar to if people came at me and then were like, bro, you didn't provide a ring. What the fuck? You know, it's like, it's not. Nothing set in stone. It's not a real thing. Like, fuck off. Like, it's real life shit that we're dealing with here. The thing I think a lot of these kids also don't understand is, like, Salvo plays shit up for his YouTube channel.
But he seemed
genuinely mad in that phone call, though. That was the first time I think I've heard Salvo, like, actually, it sounds like he was actually upset at Bowblax. What do you think about that?
I think he's, you know what it sounded like to me? It sounded like a father who is dealing with, or a teacher in his case, who's dealing with students or his kids.
Because Salvo is a teacher, right? That's what he did for a living.
Exactly. And he's dealing with these kids, and he's put all these trust and effort into these kids to try and teach them, you know, normal things. And then he sees them going off and doing the wrong thing. So it's disappointment, which builds up to a frustration level. And eventually you're going to snap at that point when they just keep going on and on and on about literal fucking nothingness with no leg to stand on. But the problem is, these people who don't have real life experience have audiences that will simp for them at every single moment.
These are the
thought
leaders.
So they're getting big upped on
Can you imagine that? A fucking thought leader has never had a real job? Like, what kind of reality are we living in?
Well, it's like, imagine if the president had never worked a job in their life. Like, any president.
Exactly.
Exactly. Know,
that's just so weird.
We would be outraged. Like, it would be the same as, like, you know, if we voted in, like, fucking Markiplier as the president. It would just be fucking stupid. You know.
Okay, so what do we think about, like, later on in the phone call, Bowblax goes on, and we'll watch this a little bit later on, but Bowblax basically says that Salvo has a flamenco moment. Now, what do you think possessed him to say something like that?
Bowblax, I would say, to put it simply, it's autism. Like,
that's exactly what it is at the end of the day. And listen, I've heard Bowblax go on these long rants about, and he believes this. I think that he believes this, how autistic people are, like, secretly the master race. Have you ever heard him say this type of shit?
Yeah, like, autistic people have, like, superpowers and shit
like
that.
Yeah,
you've
heard
that.
Yeah, so he fully believes this. But at the, it's like, okay, so on one hand, you believe autistic people are superior, but on the other hand, you can't read social cues, so you fuck up news stories. So it's like, which one is it?
I'm not going to trust an autistic person to deliver me news. It's like
especially
my podcast co-host.
Breaking news, by the way. Breaking news, too.
Yeah, exactly. I think even on Twitter, I'm not like a big person by any means, but I was like, all right, I'm going to wait and see what happens here, because I don't think Salvo's in the wrong at all. I think, like, yeah, okay, like, you know, until Salvo had actually spoken on it, I didn't know what was going on. And then I saw what was going on, and I'm like, wait a fucking second. He's not in the wrong. But of course, you know, I think the other side of it is these people see this as easy content. This is all about their wallet at the end of the day.
Right.
They don't realize that, like, look, Salvo's now, you know, full-time doing YouTube, doing this sort of stuff. This is now, like, his full-time profession. And if you are going out and saying things that are not correct of his character, that can affect his bottom line.
It's especially funny because this is exactly what they accuse Salvo of doing, of, like, this, like, salacious, crazy guy who... Oh, what do you expect from Salvo? He's crazy. He gets everything wrong, yada, yada. I don't know. Everything that I've seen him do has seemed to come correct. And these people are fucking, like, it's funny because they're using this opportunity to go after Salvo, but they're just so wrong about it because they just can't parse through this info, because not only do they have no ability to read social cues, but they also have never worked a fucking job. So it's like a combination of all these factors coming together to show us, like, a lot of problems with this fucking commentary community. And it's like, disappointed in some of these fucking stupid fans who you see them in the chat, like, like Sal Minko, or, you know, they'll say shit like that. And it's like, wow, these people, like, really have no ability to parse through information on their own. Like, it just needs to be told to them, and then, like, everything needs to be disseminated. They can't come up with something on their own.
Yeah, no independent or critical thought comes from them whatsoever. You know, they see an opposing... The thing is, they love to be in their little hug boxes, no matter what they want to admit. They love being in hug boxes that
Well, they're all in private group chats.
Their opinions.
You know what I
mean?
Yeah,
exactly. And you know what it is? That's utterly cowardly. Like, you know, if you got a fucking issue with someone, just fucking state
just
it.
Fucking
it,
say
that's
it.
What
it's
being...
just the internet. Like, who cares? Yeah. It's more fun if you get into like a big public beef. Like, who cares if you burn some bridges? Oh, they're just 100... stupid internet people.
Dude, legit. Like, the thing is, are you ever going to meet 90% of the people you fucking interact with? No, you're fucking not. Like,
and even if you do, just, that's even better. That's even better if you run into them.
Yeah. Like, look at perfect an example that's not really in this space, but like, look at Hassan when people have been going up to him about the fucking Sam Hyde fight.
Some of the funniest clips on Twitter all day. Those have been cracking me the fuck up. Maybe we'll watch those later, but yeah, those are great.
But basically in this, right, a big part that I see for me is, as well, it was something I mentioned in the chat. It's basically, I know for, like, you can see for a fact, Augie is scared of Salvo, Bowblax is scared of Salvo, Negociorio is scared of Salvo, and the reason they're
scared of Salvo
is... And
they've been waiting to take a shot, by the way, and that's another reason I wanted to talk about this story, is because they were sucking his dick, and now they had a moment to take some shots, and they took full advantage.
Yeah, because basically my view on this is they like easy targets. They like to attack easy targets. But when someone comes in who isn't completely fucking brain dead and actually has their own thoughts and opinions, can do an argument, can debate their side of things, can conduct their business properly, it scares them because it means, shit, what happens if he comes for us? We're gonna fucking lose. So what they want to do is, okay, this is basically nothing, let's push this to be something so we can get Salvo the fuck out of here so only our opinions matter. Like, that's all they want. They want this entire community to be, we have made the rules, you have to abide by our predisposed discussed rules, and if you come in with any logical decision that, you know, in any way conflicts with what we believe, you are now incorrect by, you know, court of public autistics.
I like that, the court of public autistics. What a scary court system it is. They don't know up from down.
That's what I see on Twitter 90% of the time. It's like, you know, I see a lot of these people.
I'm going to cut you off really quick. I'm seeing Edwin in the chat right here. I'm going to say this. The two people who I genuinely actually like in the commentary community are Salvo and Edwin, because they both seem like they're actual fucking human beings. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
They're the two guys I see that don't have autism mind control devices to manipulate these fucking weirdos. You know?
They're not pumping estrogen in with a colostomy bag, essentially.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, Edwin comes at things, I think, from you know, he likes to see all points of view, but he likes tipster too.
I like tipster too, because tipster is able to take a joke, and I appreciate the living shit out of that. So those three guys.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, like, even, for example, like, and I will say this, and I don't give a fuck if he wants to come at me. Come at me, don't come at CJ. Augie, you are a fucking scared little boy. Like, you are a scared little boy. Salvo scares the absolute living shit out of you.
I co-sign all this. Like,
he scares the absolute living shit out of you, and it's because you were homeschooled, you're a little Christian, you're scared of your sky daddy, like... Get out of your
legally,
fucking little box.
I think legally, homeschooled children should be obligated to go door to door and tell everybody that they've been homeschooled. Like, I think, you know, it should be like a content warning before an Augie video. Like, warning, the commentator who made this content has been homeschooled. He's retarded. He doesn't know anything. And then
experience incoming.
Like how they do it right before Jackass and shit like that. That needs to be before Augie videos.
He's the same. Like, Nick, I would say, is a little bit less like that. He just...
Dude, what is up with Nick and Augie's weird fucking relationship? They're such bizarre little butt buddies. I only ever hear Nick when I hear Augie. The two of them are always fucking pecking. It's like how hippos have little fucking birds that sit on their head and eat the parasites. That's what that shit is like. Yeah.
I do have a theory that Augie is, you know, because like when he sees anyone mention something slightly queer or anything like that. Even Salvo had kind of like brought up his sex life once in a live call, and Augie got very uncomfortable. And usually the people that get very uncomfortable by those sort of conversations when it's joking around are usually scared because they're scared that they're actually gay.
It's kind of like how Ted Cruz had the strongest reaction to cuties. It's kind of like, okay, Ted, we know you're whacking it to cuties.
Yeah, there's something sus about that. And, you know, I think Nick's the same. I think Nick is definitely a bit of a chubby gay boy. And I also think that Augie is. And look, I got no problems with queers. I'm technically, like, anyone could call me a fag. I don't care. I'm a fag. But it doesn't, you know what? I would rather be a fag who's open and, you know, living my truth than sitting in a closet calling other people gay. You know, it's projecting.
Nick is in New York, right? I could probably find him some really sexy twink gay boys for him to have sex with if he's interested. So listen, but well,
you got to make sure they're Christian.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, is that a big thing for him?
No, that's just Augie is. He always brings up the fact that he's you know, a good Christian boy, and obviously they're, you know, sending each other their dicks and stuff like that. So,
yeah, oh,
you know, I don't even want to know what goes on in their personal group chats. And the other point I wanted to state that's very clear about
okay,
this
and
situation.
Then, and then after this, do you know about do you know about the other video, the $70 Keemstar video? Because if you do, I can keep you in here and we can go through some of that stuff as well. But yeah, continue with what you're saying, and then we'll move on.
With this situation, Clara and I actually discussed it. Basically, the reason I think that Salvo got so frustrated as well is a group chat, regardless of who's in it, is not a private space. There are other people there who can discuss things.
Agreed.
If you're wanting to have a private conversation, you have it one-on-one. It's like if I wanted to talk to a family member privately, I'm not going to bring multiple family members with me to discuss it. That makes it therefore not private. And also, Nick and Augie are not to be trusted. They've shown this as a track record. They don't like Salvo, and everyone knows that. And those two guys were in that group chat. So what does Bowblax expect?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it does seem like very, they give me like Littlefinger from Game of Thrones vibes, you know what I mean? They're like whispering in everybody's ears, acting like they're not doing shit, but they're causing all sorts of fucking problems. That's like their whole MO. Well,
you know what I would also say at the moment, for them, this is dry. Their content is dry. They've got nothing to actually discuss, so they will make shit to discuss because they can't just be like, there's nothing to discuss. Well, maybe I'll go for a run. Maybe I'll go to a bar. Maybe I'll go hang out with some friends. No, they're stuck online and they got nothing to talk about.
But that's what I do too. I make up stuff for me to talk about. But that stuff, it ends up being fun. Like, I'll make up a lie that Dylan Burns never went to Ukraine, and then he'll make a video about how crazy I am, then I get to react to that. So it's like...
That's... You know what I would call that, though? You're having fun with it. You're having fun with it.
That's the difference! Some of these guys aren't having fun with this internet shit. It's like, why the fuck are you here if you're not having fun?
Yeah, this is the thing. Like, I don't know. I've been on the internet since, like, you know, we're talking like the Ogrish days, you know, back when Ogrish was an actual website. Like, the internet is not meant to be a place where everything is so fucking serious. Like,
agreed.
If people want to fuck around and have a joke, let them fuck around and have a joke. The whole thing with Salvo that I've seen, at least, and I observed it, like, pretty much immediately is, you know, it was clear, like, when he was talking to Xylene, he kept saying, honey, he's playing a character. He's playing into a bit.
We're doing a fucking show. It's like, that's what these people don't get, because they fucking turn their stream on and they start playing fucking Sonic the Hedgehog instead of doing a fucking show. It's like so disrespectful.
I will say you had a great take about Sonic, and I completely agree with it. If you're an adult and you fucking play Sonic, you're either going to turn out to be a femboy, a degenerate brony, fake trans person who gives yourself an unclit, or you're going to fuck little children. That's just my thought. And also, if someone tells me they like Sonic and they're above the age of 12, I'm like, okay, you don't need to go to a doctor anymore to be diagnosed with autism. You've just confirmed that you have it.
Agreed. Okay, here, let's move into that other drama. Okay, so I guess it started with that video, right? Do you know what that video is called? The guy, the person that put it out is called like Keemstar Show Owes Me Money or something like that.
I think it was Owes Me Money for a trailer.
Okay, if anybody can help us find this clip as well, that would be fucking fantastic.
It was utterly ludicrous.
Do you know what
like,
the guy's name was? Do you know what the channel name was or anything like that?
No, I'm sure I can find it on Salva's Twitter though.
Okay, yeah, let's get that going. Because I have the evidence that the whole drama has been manufactured by Keemstar. But you know what's so good about this? So it actually has worked out so well because from my perspective, I think that Keemstar put Salvo through like a stress test where he like put him in a scenario where he was like trying to fuck his shit up and see how Salvo handles it. That seems to be that's my theory for what happened, by the way.
Monkey's got us the video.
Monkey's got the video. Okay, cool.
Where dropped the Keemstar tweet with it. Yeah, it's in the chat, like in the Discord.
Oh, it's in the Discord chat. Okay, cool. Okay, let's see here. Oh, there it is. Okay, so yeah, it starts with the Keemstar tweet here. And again, it's like, okay, Salvo must have been so fucking... I think Salvo was probably pissed that Keemstar was doing this. I think Keemstar was trying to antagonize Salvo. I think that's what this was at the end of the day.
Yeah.
He was just trying to fuck his shit up for no apparent reason other than just being a fucking cunt. Because that's what Keemstar does. Like, I almost give Keemstar a pass. Like, you know, I'll make fun of 90% of these people for, like, selling G Fuel and, you know, being friends with FaZe Clan. But, like, Keemstar's almost, like, so evil, you would just expect him to do that. And it makes him more interesting that he's doing all this, like, evil internet shit, you know?
Well, someone had a take on that, and they were like, oh, you know, I prefer someone who is an upfront, outright douche. I don't like people who are douches behind the scenes and then fake being a good person online. If you're going to be a cunt, like, sorry, I say cunt because I'm Australian. If you're going to be a cunt, just be a cunt always.
Yeah.
And that I can respect that about Keem.
At least it's consistent.
He embraces it. Yeah, exactly. You know what to expect from Keemstar. Nothing is like, oh, shit, how did that happen?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, here, let me share my screen and we can start watching this Keemstar video here.
I saw a server that you were just in that I've been banned from.
Wait, what's up?
I saw one of your servers and I've been banned in it.
Oh, you have been? Oh, that sucks to be you. All right, is it sharing properly? Can you see it?
Yeah.
Okay, here, let's watch this video. So this is where it pops up, right? Hey, moron, Salvo Pancakes, you need to pay this person if this is real. I literally told you to make the trailer. I didn't know you hired somebody. I didn't know you hired somebody. And then didn't pay them. That's what Keemstar says. That's the claim, right? I didn't know you hired them, and you didn't pay them. So let's watch the claim.
Apparently, I was reached out to by Salvo Pancakes to edit a trailer for the Keemstar show. According to Salvo, they agreed to pay me $70 for my work. However, it's been over 2 weeks, and I've attempted a number of times to reach out to Salvo to no avail.
I'm telling you, when I saw this, I was kind of like, God damn, is Salvo like scamming editors? That I definitely felt like a type of way about that. I was like, if Salvo is doing this, that's like kind of shitty. You know what I mean? Like, what do you think when you heard that?
Well, I was like, yeah, if he's actually provided the product, that's not really a good thing here. But I also, like, knowing Keemstar, if this was a legitimate issue, Keem would have brought it to Salvo in DMs. It wouldn't have been like, this is the thing that other people aren't getting as well.
That's and the I autism. Think we all got that's it. The we, autism right there. They can't tell the difference.
Yeah. We all knew it was a joke. We all saw it and we were like, your initial reaction is, oh, that's fucked up. But then you think about it. Why is it a public tweet then? It wouldn't be a public tweet. It would be in DM.
Especially considering Salvo it's a drama show. That's the whole show is called.
Yeah,
Keemstar, Mr. Drama Alert, is causing drama publicly. Like, come on. Alarm bells aren't going off.
Who'd have thought? It's just fucking it's idiot. Wild, you know. And you see all these like kids in the little discords that really like have these parasocial relationships with like Salvo and shit, and they're all taking this and dragging it and trying to make their own content out of it. And getting,
I love,
you know,
that though. I think that's fun. I like it when people are starting to fucking twist this shit around. And don't get me wrong, the drama element is fun. I like how people are trying to fucking tear Salvo down because it makes it so much more interesting. Because now we have the definitive dub, so now there's winners and losers. That makes the conflict so much better, you know? All right.
My frustrations
watching.
To Buster Live about not being paid when I dropped everything I was doing to create a time-sensitive trailer under the impression that I was actually going to be paid for my work. I have a screenshot from Buster and Salvo's conversation.
I love how Keemstar always doxes himself when he screen records videos.
I know.
He'll have all his DMs pop up.
He never thinks to put himself on fucking Do Not Disturb when he's recording a screen. Like, it, you know, that just shows that he's been on the internet for a long fucking
time. And
what
is Chris the Narc talking about here? He goes, if I'm paid a shit ton to just train and see a specialist for my back while working out, what the fuck is he talking about? Why
so
does
that was
Keemstar
about,
need to... Is he trying to get a massage from Keemstar? Like, what is he doing?
It was from the end of the Keemstar live show when Salvo and Chris were wrestling. I think it had something to do with them talking about having Chris the Narc box someone or some shit, and he wanted to actually
Keemstar's gonna
train for it.
He's gonna leak some really sensitive information one of these days just by like his stupid DMs popping up because he's trying to do drama really quick.
Yeah, he's got to keep up with the pace of the information coming out. But you know, if you're gonna do that, you need to be smart about it, man.
Somebody in chat give me a good idea. So they're like Chris the Narc boxing. That would be awesome. Who'd be cool for Chris the Narc to box? To think here. Who's his size? He's like kind. What is he like? 5'8", like maybe like 160 pounds or something.
Yeah, yeah. I'd say. I'm trying to think. I'd love to see him.
Augie. I think him and Augie would be a great.
Yeah.
Matchup. That'd be a great. But guys, start spreading
that's a one round.
Augie versus Chris the Narc match. Because if Augie isn't willing to do his fucking RFC show, he's got to start training.
Oh,
simple
absolutely. He's got no excuse. He's got no excuse.
He's got no
otherwise,
excuse.
Well, he is sitting in his apartment with his, with his openly gay roommate. So I guess, you know, he gets a bit busy. He can't do his RFC show at the moment.
Want to co-host tonight for a bit. Sure, Edwin, I'm down. Yeah, that sounds like fun. Yeah, I'm down. And Edwin, if you want to hop in this call at any point too, you're more than welcome. So,
Nah, Edwin hates me. He ain't going to jump in if I'm here.
Oh, that's even better. Wait, why does Edwin hate you?
Because I don't know, a shitster.
Okay, so we saw that. Now let me show you guys the evidence. So remember, Keemstar is saying that, he didn't know about this, so Salvo breached his trust because he was using the Keemstar show name and promising all this money, but Keemstar is saying he didn't know about any of these transactions. So...
Mm-hmm.
Listen, and again, it's like if these guys waited one fucking day, they would have known that that is just complete horseshit. So I'm going to pull that up right now. And thank you, Clara, for all the links, by the way. You've been absolutely on fire.
Oh, Clara.
See that.
You know,
Clara's low key the best person in the. I think Clara's low key the best person in the commentary community. She is spot on about all this shit.
You know why? She's not terminally online, she has a fucking life.
Oh, and then we're going to watch this, and then I'm getting rid of you because we have another caller coming in. You guys are not going to want to miss this. We got a really funny fucking spin on all this. Let me actually just send this guy a message. 10 minutes. Okay. Stay there. Okay. So let us watch the thing I wanted to show you.
All right. Hell yeah.
Here we go. Can you see it?
Yep.
Okay. Let me switch to that.
What? Wait, I'm sorry. Hold on. Wait. Keemstar wanted you to edit a trailer.
Look, I can give you a quote. I don't have recordings of this, but Keemstar said to me exactly, I'll pay you back for this by however much it is. I'll pay you back for however much you have to spend.
And then you didn't get paid at all because they didn't hire you for the trailer. Yeah. So you just you paid for this song, which I assume wasn't like crazy expensive.
No,
you
it was like $25.
I mean, he's got that like gross fucking like New York Staten Island Long Island accent. It's fucking disgusting. Oh,
yeah. Like, well, you know what it is? He's a chutty little fucking wannabe mafioso, but
a little bit. But he's more like remember the bagel boss guy who had the shit fit in the fucking bagel store? That's like what Nicholas DiOrio really is, though.
You know who I think Augie is, if we have to think of online Spurgs? I think of the trumpet guy that was yelling at the guy in New York.
Oh my god, the little short like gnome.
Yeah, the guy who was like,
"Who the fuck are you? You're nothing. You're nothing. You're no talent."
Bowblax and Augie whenever they get on stream. That's what I hear from Augie. That's what I hear from Bowblax.
Oh my god.
"You're nothing."
Guys, give it up for Sosa for that. Here, I'm gonna play that video just to show you guys how good of an impression that was. Oh my god. Wait, trumpet guy.
You can search trumpet guy.
There he is. There he is. You type in trumpet guy, it's the first thing that pops up.
This video never fails to make me laugh.
You know who else puts on a fake accent, by the way? Jackson Hinkle, the guy who does like all the Russian propaganda shit. He like does like a fake Baltic accent to try to like act like he's like Russian or something, even though he's from California. It's pretty funny.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, apparently someone in the chat has just said Augie just tweeted he has a huge leak.
Well, you know what it is? They're looking for some form of attack right now because this is so humiliating. So I'm sure they're grasping for straws, looking for a way to fire back.
Get out! Oh, absolutely. Abso-fucking-lutely.
Here, where does it get good? Oh, here we go. Most replayed.
Okay. Everything has gone wrong in this world. Yeah. You are self-consumed, no talent, mediocre piece of shit. And I've earned my right to say it. Okay?
This is how Augie feels.
That's Augie.
In 1975, I walked Bob Dylan up on stage. Who the fuck are you? I knew.
Who the fuck are you?
Spot on. Who the fuck are you?
I don't
know. Who
the fuck
are you?
This,
you're nothing.
But,
you're no talent.
Star said,
"Wow, that's so good. You're good at that. Fucking. Thanks, there man. We go. I'm giving it up
to me exactly." I'll pay you back for this by however much it is.
We got like 40 people in the stream right now. Yesterday, everything was going good. The stream was going great. And then I went on Stardust panel and it all fell to shit. Thanks a lot, fucking Stardust. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Pay you back.
You know what? I think Stardust is fucking weird. She is a fucking unhinged.
No, I'm on her team. Listen, I'm team person. Stardust now. I'm team Stardust, but you know.
Oh, come on. Why, man? Why?
Listen, because I think we could de-radicalize her. I think she just needs to leave certain social circles and she could be You know what they're doing with the Uyghurs in China? We could do something like that with Stardust, I think. I could see light at the end of the tunnel. That's the only reason why.
Okay. Yeah, probably.
And then you didn't get paid at all because they didn't hire you for the trailer. Yeah. So you just you paid for this song, which I assume was like crazy expensive.
No, it was like $25.
Yeah, like
$25. I was expecting $3, dude.
Oh my God,
you
shut
wait.
Up.
So
these guys can't imagine spending money on their videos. That's the other funny thing about that. You spent $25 on a video. It's like some of us spend money on our products, dude.
That's the thing. Like, they watch videos and they make videos, right? And if you notice, all the music is royalty free. They don't bother to hit up artists that they like or that they know. You can just DM a band and be like, hey, like, if they're a smaller artist or something, 90% of the time, if you go, hey, can you just whitelist, like, I'm making a video or I'm a small streamer and I want to put your music in my video because I think it'd fit. I like your music. It's free promo for you. 90% of the time, they'll go, fuck yeah, let's go. I've got like at least, I don't know, 8 or 9 bands right now that have played in front of 5,000 people that are on whitelist because I've requested for them to be on whitelist.
And this
it's
like,
it just goes easy off.
You know what it is? They don't listen to music. They don't know bands. They don't have friends. So they don't have any people to reach out to. You know? Yeah,
exactly. It's all, this is all they have on their Twitter timeline is shit like this. I bet if you go to their follows, there is no, like nothing outside of their own little drama spheres.
Yeah. Okay, let's finish this clip where the editor admits that Keemstar, well, you'll see.
He owes you $25 too?
I don't care. I don't care about the
money. I know you don't care, but come on, bro.
I know. And Keem was the one that said he would reimburse me. I'm just saying. He was the one that said that on the phone.
And there you have it. You know what I mean? Just wait one day and then you'll get the info. Keemstar knew about this all along. He was just putting Salvo through a little bit of shit to see how he would respond to it. And huge egg and on also, their face, man. Huge egg.
What I will say with Nick there as well, the kid is saying he doesn't care, right? The editor is saying he doesn't care because he's probably had this happen before. He's a freelance editor. You know, sometimes projects don't go through. And you see Nick trying to bait him to care.
Right. Right, right, right.
Like, he's trying to be baited to care. And it's like, no, dude, if the guy is, if the editor himself, the source of this information, the source of where you're trying to create this drama from, is saying it doesn't matter, you can't just suddenly try to make it matter because you aren't involved.
Right. Okay.
You can't even say that Keem didn't know about this one because he's the one who said
no,
because
I have,
reimbursed
let me see
you.
If I have, I think I have text messages where, Keem, I was showing them some of the AI art that I generated for this.
Listen to this.
And
full
Keem
admission.
Says, send more. Like, so Keem knew it was being created.
Oh, this my.
Me. I mean, shout outs to Keemstar for doing such a good job with this, by the way. I mean, you really just kind of have to give it up to him. Like, this, he is, like, truly an artist.
People love to doubt Keem and his ability to fuck with people online these days, but no, he's look, he never missing the blog TV days.
He's
not missing now.
He caused every single person in the commentary community to make a fake story. That's what he did.
Oh, yeah. And it was by a simple tweet. It was a simple tweet.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, literally.
This is like, this is like, I mean, it's just as easy to fuck with, like, BX Bullet. Like, why are these people, why is it as easy to trick these people as it is to trick BX Bullet? You know, that's so embarrassing for them.
Well, you've got the fake intellectuals. These people all wish they were Destiny or, you know, someone with an actual intelligence level. But, you know, most of them are just complete and utter fucking idiots.
Right. Okay. Well, I think that sort of brings us to the end of that segment. Thank you so much, Sosa, for coming by and giving us, like, a little bit of, you know, sort of insight on a lot of this shit. I think it's valuable hearing, like, what different types of people are thinking about this. So I appreciate that, man.
No dramas, man. All right. Alrighty. All the best.
Take it easy, man. Okay, that was Sosa. So now that we can see that Salvo has been completely vindicated from all these stories, I mean, he just has completely been proven to have not done anything wrong, essentially. We can look at the people who pointed their ire at Salvo and, you know, maybe some of them have some skeletons in their closet. So I'm going to pull in the next guest here. Hello, hello. What's going on?
Hey, what's poppin'?
How we doing, man?
Yeah, I'm doing well. I mean, I'm running off of like 4 hours of sleep, but I'm tugging through.
Okay. All right, so do you want to just kind of like introduce yourself?
Yeah, all right. So, yeah, I'm TV Orange Man on YouTube. I just kind of make sketch comedy videos, kind of just the sort of stuff I want to make. Usually it's like the same sort of content you see on like TV Filthy Frank or something, but yeah, it's kind of just my own thing. But typically it's just my own stuff, but I also like to go into the commentary community and
All right, so what are you doing in the commentary community? So like, from what I understand, you do editing for some of these guys, right? Is that what I'm hearing?
Oh, no. So, you are definitely thinking of Nicholas owing me. Like, I gave Nick $50. That's what you saw, right?
Oh, so these guys owe you money. Okay, could you just give me a rundown on, from, like, your words, like, what is going on with this money situation you have?
All right, yeah. So let me just, I'll start from the top. So basically, late last night, the three, Augie, Nicholas, and Bowblax were just talking in the call, and they were talking about this whole scamming situation with Salvo, and I honestly don't know much about it. I couldn't give an educated guess on it or take, but Bowblax made an interesting point that if he found out that Augie or Nick was responsible for the same sort of scamming that he was accusing Salvo of, he would also confront Augie or Nick. And okay. I was like, okay, well, there is this one situation that I have with Nick where about in December of 2021, his podcast channel, the Half Baked Podcast, had a channel review membership where you could pay $50 and they would review your YouTube channel that you submit to them, mm-hmm. right? And I did that. And
wait, so what are you paying for when you pay them $50 to review your channel? What are you getting out of that money?
Oh, they just take a look at your channel, give you'd probably get a sub boost or attention to your channel from their audience, and they'll also give you any criticisms or compliments that they have to offer.
So it's $50, 25 of that money is going to auditing your channel, and the other half is going for some promotion, basically.
I don't really know what the $50 is. I'm guessing it's just going to Nicholas's purchase of V-Bucks on Fortnite or something.
Yeah, it's just weird. I'm just confused by this whole you paying him $50. You sound kind of stupid for giving him that money to begin with.
Well, yeah. that was the thing. Back at the time, I had 3K subs, so I was wondering if when I invested that, I'd get a considerable sub boost. So yeah, I did that, and however, as the months went on, it wasn't it was not dropping the channel review, and I was very patient and with the entire thing. Everyone was because there were multiple people involved, right?
Mm-hmm.
It was like a batch of channel reviews, and at one point I have a whole Google document about it, about all the back and forth. So they shut down the Patreon because they were having trouble with giving back the rewards or making private streams for all the people that are paying, but they said they eventually got around to the point where in June they were going to record and publish the channel review, but that is the last time they talked about it. So after that, I was trying to contact them, trying to figure out if they were still going to do it or if I was going to get a refund. And I never really was able to get around to it. Again, in the Google Doc, I talk about all this already. I basically I was blocked by Nick on Twitter because I called him a bowling ball under his.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to like that. He doesn't the bowling ball talk.
Yeah,
part of the $50 it sounds like is the fact that he would publish a video of your channel, right? So you paid him that money, kind of expecting him to publish a video of your channel.
Yeah, basically on his podcast, they just bring up your channel. Watch your videos.
Dude, that is such a fucking... Even if, he did deliver on that, that's still a fucking scam. That's ridiculous.
Well, okay, here's the thing, CJ. When I dropped the Google document, just bringing up how all this happened, because in the end, I had to make a public statement about this at some point, but I thought this would be the perfect time because Bowblax made a point about how if Nick or Augie was doing something like this, he'd confront them. So
sounded like you just said the N-word, by the way. The way your words just flowed together sounded like the N-word. But continue.
Oh, no. That happens a lot. I'm sorry. But I didn't mean for that to happen. But
donate $50 to something. You'll be good.
Okay, I'll do it after the stream.
I mean, you're just throwing your money around, it looks like, so you might as well.
Yeah, I hurt. I worked so hard for that, to make that investment, man.
Sorry. Sorry to derail you. Okay. Keep going. Keep going.
So I basically dropped the Google Doc, and Salvo picked it up because he was very he was very interested in like getting some return fodder for the whole scamming accusations. So seeing that Nicholas Fiorio was doing something similar would be the perfect shield, and that's basically what went on until Nick dropped the channel review, because it turned out that he actually did record it. He just left it in his hard drive for 5 months.
Okay, so in his mind, he thinks that the fact that he just like made it and it's sitting on his storage device, that's him fulfilling his obligation in his eyes.
I guess. I don't know. About 10 months ago, I put in the payment. 5 months later, they make it. And then 5 months later, they publish it. So that's all I have to say. I don't really know what else to
What are you looking for out of this? Like, are you trying to get your money back? Are you trying to get recognition? Do you have some type of a gripe with Nicholas Diorio? Like, what's your motivation in all this?
Oh, I just wanted to see the review. That was about it. He dropped it, and I honestly just want to make this point. I'm not like a hard ass about Nick or anything. I'm actually like, I like the review, and I like that he was able to finally publish it. It just kind of sucks that it took so long.
Wait, when did he publish it? So he published it recently.
He published it today, right after my public my Google document reminded him to upload it.
Okay, so if he scams you, you just have to harass him and feed info to his enemies, and then he will fulfill his financial obligation. Is that how that works?
Well, that's kind of the point I was making, like on my Twitter. I was like, you gotta provoke him for him to do anything, you know?
Yeah,
he's
for
not
real.
Gonna do anything otherwise.
That, I mean, that's just poor behavior, man. It's just poor behavior. It's like, if you agree to do something, especially for that price tag, and especially something so stupid as like you do like a video of somebody's chant, somebody paid you $50, just put the fucking video up. You know, like why run somebody like that through the ringer? It just doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know. I was chasing him about like trying to talk about it for the past like couple months, but I'm just happy that it's out now. Kind of stinks that I had to make a whole like scene about it, but honestly, it was kind of fun. Would do it again.
Why are you upset about making a scene? I mean, I got content out of it. You got content out of it. We caused some problems. I mean, this has been fantastic. Our team took the W.
Yeah. I guess that's just what I say, because like I just expect the easiest thing would be like he'd drop it after it was recorded, but it's just not what happened.
Oh, and so Clara in the chat is saying he admitted he wouldn't have he would have forgotten it without the Google Doc. So he's admitting that he would have. So it's like, how many other people have paid him $50 and haven't gotten their shit fulfilled?
I don't know about other people. I do know that because in the most recent Half-Baked podcast, there's about four channels he reviewed, including mine. So it's I don't know if there's any more. I'm pretty sure there's not. I'm pretty sure that's it. But yeah.
Got it. Okay, is there anything else that you want to add? Like, how do you feel about this scenario? Give us some thoughts here, and then we might end up moving on in a little bit.
Yeah. So, one thing I did want to say is Nick actually went above and beyond, because I told him no, you can't just wait 5 months and drop this. You got to pay me with interest.
Well, so, you know, now you also have 80,000 subscribers. So you coming after him means a little bit of a different thing now than it did back then.
That's a good point.
Isn't it interesting how, like, when somebody has clout, Nick will actually do stuff. But if people don't have clout, he'll just take advantage of them. That's so weird.
Yeah. Matt Pitt made a good point where it was like, if they actually dropped a channel review while I was still small, then like that channel review, I just think that's how I blew up, and that just haunted me forever. So it's a good thing it took this long.
Right,
that's funny. But yeah, so I got Nick to make a reaction on his Twitch to my most recent video, which honestly I thought was pretty fun. I enjoyed it. So I think we're pretty chill now. We're pretty cool. So I think I like how it wrapped up. One thing I do want to say is Bowblax. I thought it in the Google Doc, I thought that when I told him about this, about Nick not returning with the channel review, he said that he didn't want to get in the middle. And I thought he was being hypocritical, but he reached back to me later. It was like, oh, he thought I was talking about Salvo. He thought I was saying that Salvo also scammed me. But
oh, because
no,
he's looking, he's so hungry, looking for dirt on his own. That's so funny, because he's looking for editors that have gotten scammed. So he thinks that you're on his team.
Dude, I wouldn't. I'm just telling you now. I would never like edit a full VOD in KineMaster in 360p.
Yeah. What do you think about that? It's like, if Salvo asks for a 20 to 30 minute video and somebody sends him a 2 hour video in 360p. Who in their right mind would expect a delivery on that payment? That's psychotic.
Yeah. I know. From what I've heard of that situation, that seems more than reasonable to not expect a payment for something like that.
Yeah, so like as an editor, like how do you think about a scenario like that? Like, cuz to me it's like when you're editing a video for somebody, they expect a certain product, and if you don't deliver the product, they just don't pay you. That I mean, it seems pretty simple and shut. Like, don't you? How could you see it any other way, right?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's it's just as basic like a contracting.
Yep. Cool. Well, dude, thank you so much. Any last words you want to add? Anything you want to shout out?
Is homeboy Edwin like Alabama Edwin?
Is it Alabama Edwin? I don't know.
I'm pretty sure that's it. He's just asking, was Orange Man unblocked? Yes, I was unblocked. Me and Nick are now mutuals. So
yeah, I'm blocked by Nick, by the way. He blocked me, so yeah. I'm part of Team Blocked, but I've been blocked by him for a couple months now.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, there's lots of people. There's lots of people with like different values and positions in the commentary community. Some people like are actually like looking to criticize. Well, I'm just here to troll. I don't really want
to. There you go. You're trying to have fun with this shit, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think I need to get to the point where I'm like Salva, where I'm constantly like self-aware and have like a sense of irony around me. That's got to be like my final form.
All right, good. I like it. We need more people with a lighthearted attitude to all this fucking internet shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, definitely. I think that's what we need to, like, I don't want to, like, go all, like, pull, massive scale and stuff, but that's what we need to bring the internet back to being fun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we need to take the autistic people, we need to take their opinions a little bit less seriously, and we got to start having a little bit more fun. I think if we could do both those two things, the internet would be a much nicer place.
Yeah.
No. All right. Well, thank you for throwing your two cents in, Orange Man. I appreciate it.
Oh, yeah,
and
absolutely.
It sounds great that Nick actually fucking paid up his end of the bargain, like, finally, but it's such a crazy thing. The amount of force you had to put on him in order to, you know, fulfill your $50 payment is insane.
Yeah. Yeah. But it is what it is.
It is what it is. All right. Take it easy, buddy.
Yeah. Thanks for bringing me on.
Of course. Peace out. So there you have it, man. I mean, again, Salvo, he is vindicated of both the editing dramas. Nicholas DiOrio is somebody that will scam people unless they have clout, and then he will fulfill their payments. So that is pretty much that. That's the coverage that I'm doing for today. Edwin, let's talk. But other than that, thank you guys so much for coming by. You know what? This has been actually such a good week. Either tomorrow or the next day, I have about 6 stories I still have to do. So I'm thinking either tomorrow or the next day, we're going to get on. We're going to be talking about Tim Dillon, his scandal with his intern, Ben Avery, who was fired. We're going to talk about Asmongold Steaks. We caught Nick Rakita being a pervert yet again, and a lot of other good shit. But thank you guys all so much for coming by. Let me get to my music playlist here, and then we will get the fuck out of here. This has been so much fun, guys. Thank you all so much for coming by. Really means the world to me. No, not that song. Not that one. We got to find a good one to leave on here. What about... We'll just go with whatever the fuck this is. Okay, thank you guys very much. Peace the fuck out. Nope, too light. Goddamn, give me a good fucking song. What the fuck? What is this music? Why do I listen to the shittiest fucking music? Every fucking... Here, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna listen to some Jesse Smollett. You guys like Jesse Smollett? My favorite person in the world? Peace out, everybody.
Broken-hearted, people are the first ones. Once they start it, they can be the worst ones. Love is a weapon if you don't use it right. Now we're watching you conform my life. Hurt people, they don't know why. Hurt people, they don't even try. We all go through things in our life that don't make the shit alright. But you don't hear me. Listen clearly.
Bye, everybody. Thank you for coming by.